Hey guys, we have a Walt Disney World trip coming up in November, and so I decided what better way to count down our trip than with an advent calendar. I chose this Lego Star Wars box, and I'm looking forward to seeing what's inside. Let's take a look.
This is Lego box number 75279, and it has great artwork. It features all of the minifigures inside against a snowy scene of trees with Christmas lights. It could be the planet Hoth. When you fold down the protective cover, it reveals the Millennium Falcon, also draped in Christmas lights, and some of the characters standing in front. When I finish this box, I plan to keep it. It's perfect for scrapbooking or making cards.
Welcome back to another pull from our Star Wars Lego Advent Calendar box. And we are so enjoying this. Every day has been a treat, and I love all of the minifigurings that we have added to our collection. Watch our previous days. Days 1 through 15 are also up on our channel if you want to see what else came out of this box. And also, I put pictures and video of everything that we pulled at the end of each video, so you can see what we pulled so far that way. But we are on day 17. Wow. Our trip is getting really close. Of course, we're getting really excited. But again, these figurines are just really neat to have. It's a lot of fun to pull them every day and put them together and have this nice little collection of Star Wars minifigurines when you get done with the calendar. So a great way to count down to a Walt Disney World trip, to Christmas, to whatever event it is that you're counting down to. Day 17, let's see what we get. Okay, it's at the bottom here. So let's make the pull. Let's see what we get. I think it's almost time for a figurine, but, or for a character, but I think, let's see. I think this is the little service droid. The little service droids that are so funny that show up, well, they show up in several of the movies, but Mando runs into these at the docking port where he stops to have his ship fixed, and these are the little droids that go in, the service droids that go in to fix the Razor Crest, and of course he doesn't want him to do it at first, and Pele, I think, is the mechanic's name, and she calls him back, and then the second time he makes a trip in, he says, I'll let him give it the once over. So that's what these are. These are so funny too. These little droids are really funny. So I'll put this one together and let you know what it looks like. Maybe give you a little more information on how these were used.
There is an assembly diagram on each flap to help with putting these together. So that's nice. As I thought, this is a pit droid. The DUM, or Dumb Series Pit Droid, was a model of repair droid manufactured by Servo Droid Inc. prior to the invasion of Naboo. Designed for maintaining pod racers, pit droids were cheap, expendable, and durable repair droids. They stood at a height of 3 feet, but had the ability to fold into a compact form when not in use. This feature could be toggled by tapping them on the nose. If one could not reach the system it needed to work on, the unit would get other pit droids to make an unstable and haphazard droid pyramid. Pit droids were also fearless when faced with unsafe tasks, going as far as to be happy to throw themselves into danger. This is a great box, and assembling each piece is an added treat. Here's a look at what we've pulled so far. If you're a Mandalorian fan, please check out our weekly live stream, Mando Mania, every Thursday at 12 p.m. Central, 1 p.m. Eastern. We talk about each episode from The Mandalorian, the hit series streaming on Disney+. Don't miss it! I'm looking forward to tomorrow's video. Please be sure to hurry back and check it out. And may the Force be with you.
Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe, and come hang out with us on social media. We're the Hitchhiking Bones, and we're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. There's always room for one more, so hurry back.